Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica Alexandria of Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Let's talk about this week ahead. I have the charts pulled, I have the cards pulled, I have my notes, and we're ready to dive in. So the first thing I want to talk about this week, starting on August 19th, is the fact that Mars, ruling our drive, our ambition, is moving into the sign of Virgo. Now, as a Virgo, I can only celebrate because I feel like this is our natural element outside of Mercury moving into the sign of Virgo. Why? Because Mercury rules Virgo. So it's just kind of like makes sense. But Mars is what we do. It's how we act. And it just feels like somehow, some way, all of the rest of the world, all of the rest of the universe is moving in the same way that us Virgos do, which is efficient, productive, and simple, meaning like work smarter, not harder. In all areas of our life, it's about purification, it's about cleansing, it's about what is good for the whole by paying attention to what doesn't serve us. The smaller details. Virgo is known for picking up on those smaller details that aren't right, but sometimes being so hyper-focused on this that they miss the bigger picture over here, and that's why we need all of the rest of the planets to kind of move together cohesively to complete this bigger, better picture that is right for all of us. Now that's a mouthful, but pretty much that's what I'm seeing at the start of this week is we are starting to streamline. We are cleaning out our closets. We are cleaning out the clutter. We are cleaning out the mess. With that comes an energy that almost is heightened. Think about the last time you drank too much coffee or you had too much black tea or green tea and it creates a little bit of jitters. It can trigger anxiety, it can trigger a little bit of restlessness, so kind of scurrying about doing the most. So go ahead and prepare and plan for that. But to move away from that, I wanna remind you guys that doing a lot of things doesn't mean that you're being efficient or even productive. In fact, there is a message here this week for all of us, which is about enjoying things and having balance within our lives, that it's not all work or all play, and we don't want to just fill our time up with things that clutter our space or clutter our energy for the sake of saying that it's filled up. Do you know what I mean? We want to make sure that anything that we're inviting into our life or that we have in our life serves a real purpose. So that's what I'm seeing as Mars moves to the sign of Virgo. It's almost like trimming out these ends or trimming out these loose ends. If it doesn't serve a purpose, it truly doesn't need to be there. And it's about seeing that for what it is, paying attention to that detail, and then analyzing it. Does this fit in with my greater picture? Is this my priority? And if it isn't my priority, then it doesn't serve a role other than the role that it is that it serves. And which could be, it can vary per person, and the answer ultimately is up to you. So that's what I'm seeing, and you guys know how I work astrology and how I work my readings. It's not only the science of it and what Mars moving through Virgo looks like, even though that is factor in, it's intuitively what it is that I'm seeing and what I'm feeling, and I articulate that message over to you guys. So as Mars moves through the sign of Virgo, and as the planets start to crowd in the sign of Virgo, because Venus is gonna be moving into the sign of Virgo as well, the Sun is gonna be moving into the sign of Virgo, and most of all of the planets, I believe, are going to be in Earth signs outside of Jupiter. There's going to be in Mercury, but Mercury will get there. Mercury is going to meet up with them later. But all of these major planets, all of our planets, are transitioning themselves into positions where they're in Earth signs. And this is about materialization. This is about not only this higher vision that we see for ourselves or our feelings, it's about being grounded and seeing the reward, seeing the effort of that starting to pay off. This is not only a vision or a concept, we can put our hands on it. And as a Virgo, I celebrate in that. No matter what your sun sign is, celebrate this materialization, this, you know, things coming together that we can put our hands on, that we can see the evidence of it. And if we don't see the evidence of it, then we have to question, is this really real? Is this really happening? And if it isn't happening, let me see why it's not, so that I can do what I need to do on my end in order to help things to move along. Now, there are two things that are coming to me this week, and it's the word ambition and the word priorities. I'm seeing that for so many of you guys have this vision that it is that you have for yourself, or this thing that you want to manifest, or this tangible evidence proof, or like proof that you want to see manifest within your life. And that's this vision that you have. But in order for that vision to manifest this week, I'm seeing paying attention to detail and being honest with yourself. What I'm seeing for this week is almost like a person taking inventory of their life. If you have this closet that you keep all of the items that it is that you need to run your business, if you have just empty things like empty bubble wrap, empty boxes that are taking up space within there. Yeah, it looks like there's something going on in there, but in reality, all that's going on in there is chaos. So if you pull out these empty broken down boxes and you pull out this old wasted bubble wrap, then you'll have not only more space, you'll have a void, but you can fill it with things that actually serve a purpose and are there for a reason that make you more efficient and more productive. So many of us in our brains, we look at this emptiness and we're like, okay, emptiness is bad. Let me fill it up and let me just fill it up with anything. That void, that hole, that space can be your heart. It could be your health. It could be your career. It could be how you're spending your time, who you're spending it with. You would almost prefer to fill it up with this, I don't want to say bad or ill or just whatever, just kind of stuffing it with stuffings. So maybe a relationship that you don't even really value, or a person that you don't really value, a friend that you don't even like. So it's like, make sure that what you're filling your space with, or that you're spending your time with, or the things that you're doing, that you're actively doing, isn't there just to keep you moving and spinning your wheels. If you think about animals that move through the desert, they do not move just for the sake of moving, because they will die out. Like the environment around them does not support them spinning their wheels and just exerting energy. The more energy that you exert within the desert, the faster you probably are going to dehydrate, and if that's the case, you're going to die. So if animals within the desert know to prioritize their moves and to move with intention versus just to move, that's what it is that I'm seeing this week. Why movement? Why action? Because Mars moving through the sign of Virgo is triggering the entire chart, for me at least, when I'm seeing this message for what is it I see for all of us. We do have some beautiful aspects this week, and I'm seeing this when it comes to creative projects. Those who are creating in general, like a business, those who are concerned with romance and relationships and dating, and also the aspect of children and play. If these are areas that you've been paying attention to, that you've been focusing on, especially with Mercury moving through the sign of Leo, which loves the fifth house energy, which are all the things that is that I mentioned just before, Mercury and Jupiter are gonna trine on the 21st of this week. And basically what we're seeing is this engaging conversation, this fun, this playfulness, this lighter vibration, this lighter energy. I started saying this last week, and the message still applies into this week, is you really want to be very careful and mindful about who is around you and who you're spending your time and your energy with, because not everybody seems to be your friend, and not everybody has or should have such a close, intimate role within your life. I don't know why that's coming through. It's coming through for me as well, which I'm being very mindful about who I'm spending my time with and how I'm spending my time with them, what I say to them, what I choose to say to them, if I even spend time with them. So if this energy is around being playful and creative, then you want to make sure that you are coming from a space of love and light, that your energy is loving and that your energy is light, that the words that you use, the thoughts that you're thinking, the music that you're listening to isn't bringing anger, isn't bringing static energy, isn't bringing more chaos into your environment, because you simply cannot afford it. If you are trying to build something and manifest a better life for yourself, why would you fill your headspace up, which is what rules your ability to create and to call and to think, you know, to set intention? Why would you fill that up with negativity? Why would you fill your energy with people who you know intuitively don't serve you or don't have your best interests at heart or are using you or whatever the case is? Maybe it's your own thoughts. Maybe your own thoughts are toxic. So there's this space this week. I don't know if you need to hang out with a new group or spend time doing things that it is that you like and that you love, that lifts your energy up and lifts your vibration up, so that you can be creative, so that the energy that you're putting out is actually sparking more creative energy for you, then do that. I have to put my hair up in a ponytail, you guys, because I try as hard as I might to wear my hair down, it bothers me every single time. I try to do it for the sake of looking cute, but honestly, my edges here in New Orleans are not here for the humidity. They're just not. Every time I, you know, slick my hair back, my edges are like, ha, we're back, girl. So then I have like these frizzy, you know, moments. So wearing my hair down is just not something I even like. Even as a kid, I used to put my hair up in a ponytail. But that's neither here nor there. You guys did not tune in today to listen to me talk about my hair. I do see an offering coming in, and it just seems to be so beautiful. And this could, again, it could be romance, it could be creativity. It's just something that serves a purpose, truly, to bring joy and light and love into your life. And if that is the case, then you need to be open to that. And if your energy, if your space is clogged down with chaos and toxicity, then whatever it is that's trying to come in, that's there to creatively spark you up and to bring joy into your life, even if it does successfully come through, it's not going to last very long, because like attracts like. If your energy is not something that is positive and constructive, you think someone who is positive and constructive is going to stay in your energy for longer than they have to? No, for the sake of self-love and self-protection, they're going to be out faster than you can be like, hey, what's up? My name is Jess. Do you know what I mean? So your energy has to kind of match what it is that you're trying to manifest. And we talked about this in a great detail in my video on the laws of attraction. So to support us through this week, if we are truly calling in these things that we're trying to manifest, that we see for our future, then we want to simplify. And by simplify, that means don't hold on to things for the sake of it filling up a space and a void within your life. Open up for new. See it for what it is. That takes a lot of accountability, and it also requires a person seeing something for what it is and, you know, accepting the truth. And if it doesn't fit with you, if it doesn't resonate, then you have to say goodbye to it. Now, for a lot of you guys, I don't see this as total cancellation out of relationships or icing people out. I just see you focusing on your future and focusing on what makes you feel inspired. And if it doesn't inspire you, it's not that you have to toss someone out or have a difficult conversation, but for some of you guys, yeah, that's what it's gonna look like. But I just see you kind of moving forward, and in the space where you were once suspended and once feeling like this hangman upright, now we're kind of loosening ourselves up because we have this new perception, this new take on life, and we're ready to proceed as the Knight of Cups. So these are the cards that it is that I'm seeing. I am seeing a lot of transitioning and changing that's happening. I'm seeing you moving and adapting, but move with intention, move with positivity, move with light, move with love. Don't just move and waste your energy and be like, oh, I'm being productive. Like, no, you're being chaotic. And that's the other thing too that will happen as Mercury moves into the sign of Virgo, which will come, but also as Mars moves into the sign of Virgo, or as Mars is moving through the sign of Virgo, we'll get that energy of like restlessness. And ask any Virgo and they will tell you that it's all about intention, it's all about what you're focusing on, and you don't want to fill up with all this busyness or you will overwhelm. It's like system overload. So what we don't want to do is to do that, because that will get you nowhere. It'll get you nowhere fast. Music. There's this emphasis around music, joy, and pleasure. What is it that you're listening to? What is it that you are creating? The music that you're listening to, the words, all of that has a vibration. So let it be something that lifts you up and lifts your spirits up, so that you are also in a space that you are creating and feeling creative. Even if you're the most logical brain, you can still benefit from this creative mindset, because it helps you to think outside of the box. If you don't find it in you, or that's not a talent that you have, then pair up with someone who can do that, so that you can take your ideas, take them to the next level. So that's what I'm seeing for all of us, the energy of this entire week. Let me go ahead and break down each of the chunks of this week. So Monday through Wednesday, Wednesday through Friday, and Friday through Sunday, and then we're gonna go through our strengths and our weaknesses. So to cover us for Monday through Wednesday, what I'm seeing is the High Priestess reversed. She was reversed at first. I'm seeing the Fool card, and I'm also seeing the Page of Wands. Now, what I feel with this is a need for emotional protection. If you truly are starting this next phase within your life, if you truly are transitioning and your life around you is changing, you are walking into this energy as the Fool. So there is this new, fresh energy, this first step, so to speak. And it's built on your confidence. It's built on your need for adventure. It's this need for, this desire for newness. It's because you're passionate and you're starting this creative project, or you're following your heart, you're following your hunches, and that's a great thing. But I can't help but to ignore the tiny little dog that for so many of us is our little familiar. It's the thing that looks out for us, whether it be a spirit guide, our friends, our higher self, or even our mom or our dad being like, look, honey, if you're gonna go on this journey, don't go into it totally naive. You need to protect yourself. You need to be fully aware. So I am seeing that as you start Monday through Wednesday, that you are being encouraged by the universe. You're being encouraged by your guides to put yourself out there, follow your passions by all means. The Page of Wands is the first to tell you to follow your passion. But even as you do that, don't be reckless and stupid about it. If you have to put, you know, protection spells around you, if you have to give a little extra time for prayer in the morning and to set intention, by all means. But what I am saying, what I do feel, is that this new start, this new fresh step that you're doing, this thing that you're initiating, that may seem crazy to the outside world, it's actually because you're called to do it. It's a part of your passion, even if it doesn't make sense to other people. But as you do that, remember that you really don't need anybody else's opinions to factor into the decisions that you make, but what you do need is protection. So call in protection, whatever that means for you. But I do see it being a good thing. And the cards that cover us for the start of this week, Monday through Wednesday, are the Fool, the Page of Wands, and the High Priestess reversed. And the High Priestess is reversed because, again, she's saying, listen, don't neglect your intuition. And if your intuition is calling you to do something which would, again, may seem like it's stupid or reckless, it's not that it is. It's not always logic all the time. It's not always a logical explanation. It's something that you feel. And you don't want to ignore that. Also, you don't want to ignore when there's red flags or there's something that's cautioning you to slow down. Follow your passion by all means, but also protect yourself. So that's what I'm seeing for Monday through Wednesday. Let's move on to Wednesday and Friday. Okay, Wednesday through Friday, there is the same energy of being independent and self-sufficient, but I can also see with that a feeling of, damn, I wish you were here supporting me. Damn, I wish I had recognition. Damn, I wish I had a little bit more support. This is with the Five of Pentacles here and the Six of Swords and then also the Six of Wands reversed. And basically what we're seeing with these cards is I am moving forward. My intention, my mind, my thoughts are about moving forward using whatever it is that I got now. Start with where you are, start with what you have. And that is very Virgo, which is kind of covering us in the last message that I said that cover us for this week, which is keep it very simple. You don't really need a whole lot in order to accomplish and to achieve your dreams and to see movement happening. You just need what you have and make sure that what you have is the right tool if you have to keep the load light, if that makes any sense. It may feel like you don't have what you need. And sometimes that is mental. There's a lot of this energy that is very mental. And because it's mental, it can deplete your energy, which is what we see with the wands. And you guys know, especially if you're part of the Sacred Circle Tarot School, that we don't read one card separately. We read them all together. They all tell a story to help us to give the bigger message, to give the bigger picture. So if this person is feeling like, I don't have enough, like I need more for myself as I'm moving forward, this need more isn't, maybe it's not necessarily actual tools and resources, because as the greater whole, as I'm looking at these cards and I'm looking at the chart, it's not that you don't have what you need, you do. You're independent, you're creative, and you're passionate. I feel like there's a sense of, I don't have people on my side or on my team, or I wish I didn't have to do this alone, or I wish I could link up with someone. And that makes me feel kind of out and isolated and lonely. So I just want you guys to realize that Wednesday through Friday, those times when you're moving through the desert, remember I used that metaphor earlier, where it seems like everything is barren, and maybe it is, but you have everything that you need, but just don't fill up your energy with people or places or things that don't serve a real purpose just for the sake of you filling that void within yourself. Because the reality is that when you feel a void, and we'll talk about this in another video because you guys have been highly requesting it, and I promise I will talk about it because it's something that I was going through and that I am moving out of right now. When you fill a void, that void will actually fuel your passion. It will fuel your creativity in that emptiness, in that darkness. So instead of looking at that as a negative thing, continue to call in the forces that be through prayer, through intention, through mindfulness, through self-awareness. Don't run from it, heal it. So that's what I'm seeing this week, Wednesday through Friday, is it feels like you're alone. It feels like these annoying, plaguing things are, you know, bothering you, or that you wish you could have someone with you. The fact that you don't, or the fact that you need more, shows you that you are going to gain more. And it's that void space that is going to help to fulfill and to fuel your steps as you move forward into the future. So just believe, and it's temporary. Everything is temporary. Even the good and the bad times, they're all temporary. When it comes to Friday through Sunday, this is what I'm seeing for us. Friday through Sunday, this is about to get good. This is truly about to get good. And this is why I'm like, don't worry about the moments where you feel alone or isolated. It's because things are just working themselves out. Things are balancing themselves out. What I'm seeing here is the Star card and the Queen of Cups and the Eight of Wands. Now, the Star card, I can never talk about this card without talking about the darkness first, and that darkness usually equates to that void, that silence. And what happens is that when this card shows up, and when you find yourself in a space in your own life where you don't know where you're going, you don't know what's happening around you, that you actually feel like you're sitting in the dark, there is a magic that is happening and that is manifesting itself. And I am seeing success. I'm seeing change. I'm seeing not only change, but like a cycle of change that is connected to the stars, that is connected to divine destiny and fate. I'm seeing Venus meeting up with Uranus on the 26th. I'm seeing Venus meeting up with Mars on the 24th. This is happening in the sign of Virgo on the 24th, with Mars ruling our drive and ambition, meeting up with Venus, the planet of relationships and beauty, the things that make us feel good. Those two powers, when they sync up and they align, they surge energy. And this is something that isn't going to be felt just on that day, but the days around it and the energy that flows from that to come. On the 26th, we're also seeing these surprises, this unexpected development, this unexpected windfall is what it is that I'm seeing. And this confirms to me even more that you are going to be on the receiving end. Why the receiving end? Because when I see the Queen of Cups, I definitely feel this energy of, I am in this position right now of receiving. I don't have to fight it. I don't have to force it. And the word just came through is, I trust. Essentially, I trust. Do I know I'm a good person? Do I know I have a good heart? Do I know that my intentions are pure? Always. I give so much out there, but just because I give is not what makes this why I should receive it. It's just, I'm lucky, like I deserve it. I don't have to do anything for this, it just comes through. And you would naturally, because you're an abundant person, you're growing in a really wonderful way. So at this weekend, I'm seeing, it just feels like things aren't what they seem, but that's not a bad thing. It's, if you are, you know what message came through, and I was working with one of my clients, or one of my students within Sacred Circle Tarot School. She was one of my victims, like I like to call it. We'll do these like, you know, mock readings. And she was one of the ones that I was randomly selected to do a reading so that the rest of the class can learn from her. And basically she was like this student, and if you're watching, I send you all of my love, but she just kept saying like, I keep telling people to tell me the truth, tell me the truth, tell me the truth. But as she said it, I intuitively knew that what she was actually saying was, tell me something bad and then I will believe it. And that's kind of what I'm seeing this week, is that so many of you guys equate trust and hearing the truth with it's going to hurt, when that's not the case. The truth does not always mean that it's something that's going to hurt you. Sometimes the truth is that you are deserving and that you are worth it and that it's going to come into your life. So don't always expect the worst outcome and call it the truth, or the truth hurts. It doesn't always. That's a mindset that is limited. That's a mindset that can only see the worst in something. So, and that's something that so many of you guys are outgrowing. So as this comes through in this darkness, it's not that you need to do or expect the worst for yourself. It's just prepare yourself to receive healing. Prepare yourself to receive luck and good future, like a good fortunate circumstances. Prepare yourself to receive success. Prepare yourself to receive, you know, love and support. It may seem like it's not going to happen. It is. And to support that even further, we have this card here that says things are about to get really juicy. I bet they are. But don't look at that as, oh, things are about to get juicy. Like, things are about to get crazy. It's not that. I actually see things working themselves out and things being lucky and balancing themselves out and you being in a space of growth and abundance. And this isn't always necessarily something that you have had to do. I feel like you've already called it out there. You've already set the intention. It's just manifesting right now. It's just all a matter of time. It's all a matter of looking at the planets, looking at the stars, and then receiving the gifts as that comes through at this surprising windfall. So that's what I'm seeing for us for this weekend, Friday through Sunday. Let's go through what's supporting us. All right, so what's working for us is so interesting. I feel as though there's like this call to action where the universe or your guides, or at least my guides, are calling out to us and saying, look, face your fears. Now, when I see that and when I feel that, I'm not saying that for you to expect the worst. I think that so much of what people want and what people desire, a part of it truly does scare them. It's a person and this mentality that humans have that when something good comes in or when we see something good, we almost second guess it and question, do we really want this? And we fear success in a lot of ways. So that's what I'm seeing here. When I see face your fears, and when I'm hearing that, like seeing that and I'm feeling that, this is a person who, with the Page of Swords, it's information that comes through and it's the truth. When you hear the truth, like, tell me the truth. Well, the truth is, like, you know, there is something new sparking up here. And with that adventure, it can come fear, it can bring with it excitement and desire and passion and ambition. Are you ready? Do you actually want what it is that you say that you want? Yes, you do. And when it comes in, are you gonna freak out when it starts showing signs that it is manifesting and that it is growing? Remember, the cards before were the Queen of Cups and the Eight of Wands. That's energy that's coming through. And the Queen of Cups can tend to anything and grow to any and allow anything to grow on it, definitely on an emotional plane. So when it comes to our intuition, our emotions, our relationships. So when this starts showing up, this is you seeing yourself for all that you are, seeing another person for all that they are, accepting it flaws and all. Just like you have a rose is so beautiful and it's so fragrant, that rose also has thorns. Instead of looking at that and being like, oh, I said I wanted a rose, but that has thorns. We all have thorns. So I'm seeing the truth is that you are ready to do whatever it takes. You are ready to receive. You're passionate here, but don't allow your, sometimes this feeling of, you know, do I deserve this? Am I ready for this? You are, you have been. But face your fears and trust that what is coming into your life is happening for the better. That is the truth. I'm also seeing how everything is so connected, that every circumstance, everything that you've started, everything that you've experienced, it brought you to this point to provide awareness to you. And when you can detach yourself from that, then you can see the greater picture, which is you are deserving of blessings. This is something that's coming into your life. All things are connected, all things are fated, and this is just a part of you harvesting and moving forward with what is going on. You have nothing to hide about yourself. You are perfect as is, and that's the energy that supports you. So facing these fears, facing the shadow, facing the imperfections, facing the flaws, and seeing the truth of that is going to help spark the rest of the journey and help to carry you the rest of the way. And it's going to be an abundant, constantly growing, constantly evolving thing that is there to make you ultimately happy. So that's what's supporting us here. Let's move on to our challenges. Okay, when it comes to challenges, what I'm seeing is this emphasis of remembering that as you see things for what they are, realize that everyone and everything is doing the best that they can with what they have. If you are starting off this new adventure and you have excitement and fear and you're using what it is that you have, like the tools and the resources that it is that you have, realize that you're not the only one. I mean, just look at this YouTube channel, for example. I have how many people that are subscribed to the YouTube channel and how many people that can resonate with the messages every week. And it's because I pull messages for the collective. But if this resonates with you, imagine how much it's resonating with someone else. And they probably are feeling the same levels of stress, but maybe it's a different area of their life. People are doing the best that it is that they can with what it is that they have. So that being said, see everything. The challenge is to see everything for a blessing. See it for what it is. And people are really trying and they are vulnerable. Like, human beings are human beings at the end of the day. I don't care how glorified you have made them, how much you've exalted them, how cool you think they are, or how much of a nerd that you think that they are. At the end of the day, if you see them for what they are, they have a heart, that heart beats, and they have fears, and they have insecurities, they have thoughts, those thoughts think. So, and the same thing is true for you. Everyone is doing their best. And a lot of people do things to seek validation and to seek approval, and it helps to have that approval. It helps to have that confirmation. It helps to hear that someone cares about you. It helps to see people are watching you and cheering you on. That being said, I'm seeing that there are a lot of people who are not seeing the best for you and are not doing the best like that they should be, or maybe their best is not enough, and that is the truth. And you may have to purify yourself of that energy. Maybe you might have to put your social media account on private for a moment because people are watching, people are seeing. It's like being in a park. Who's in that park? There's children playing, but there's also perverts. You know what I mean? So you just want to be very mindful of what's around you and be careful of what it is that you're spending that time with, who it is that you're connecting with. Not everybody that shows up and presents themselves is, you know, bringing in strength and goodness and good intentions. So, and these are things that you know because you've lived through it, you've grown through it. So that's what it is that I'm seeing. I hope that those messages resonate. If they do, let me know down in the comments. Make sure that, or if they don't, let me know down in the comments, because you do anyways. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you're subscribed because there's plenty more videos where this came from, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.